in journal, but also I collect a video that relates to Pimba. And what we're playing here is a, actually, you got it more. Is it a short? For anybody that maybe see? Maybe, yeah, half hour is a short. He was involved in the making of it. And basically, it's a war between pinball machines and video games. Video games win, but it's a lot, it's a lot of interesting. Like, the characters come alive. It's kind of a long clip, or movie. So I'm going to kind of stop it. But it's available as a 5 DVD set in journal sells for the money goes to the Hall of Fame, and included in that set is this whole movie. Actually, I cut about a minute of the video games out because we didn't care. But it's really interesting, and it's an outside of the movie, and it's not available anymore. People come up to me and say, "You have Arcade Attack?" I say, "Yeah, check there." So, let me do this. All right, so I just was sitting back there and went, "Hold on, there." Let's play this. It's an opening for the show here, an opening for the Cinemark Theaters I think in the mid-90s. And I guess I should also say that I not only collected this stuff, but I really appreciate the fact that these are not playing to us. These are playing to the public, to people that never maybe even heard of pinball or remember pinball as something way in the back. And it keeps pinball in their mind. And I have old ones, brand new ones. It's amazing even to me that it keeps happening. And they can pick video games, they can pick many kinds of images, but they seem to keep picking pinball. I mean, yes, it's an action thing, but video has things that are going, but they just pick pinball. And like we're all talking about keeping pinball alive or keeping it going. If it's not in your mind and it's not something that you know about, then it's not going to be alive. So that's really why I appreciate this. And we'll just play this. Physically. So and it cost $1 million to make this. My office is like right there, basically. Just say that. Let's see. All right, so what did I pull down? Well, while we're in sports, this is, I put football, but I believe it's actually soccer. Some of these things have been either pulled off sites or you really can't see them anymore because they're, for various reasons, not available to the public, so I like to, to show. So this, I believe, the last time I looked was not where it was supposed to be. I think it was a Samsung thing. So, again, soccer, appealing to younger people. We're doing younger people. I know, let's do this. I like this. I haven't shown this in a long time. This is, I forgot the guy's name. He's in a rock band, but he's a big Kiss collector. And I knew it, but maybe something to do. He's showing us around his apartment or his house.
Alright, I don't want to. This is a Kiss sleeper bag, which I really dig. And the KISS sleeping bag protects the KISS temple machine. This is my bedroom.
Okay. If anyone sees a name up there that they kind of want to, because I'm going to have to do them all.
As we continue. At their kid 200, please. Answer. Stern of Melrose Park, Illinois is now the world's only maker of these machines that used to rule arcades. Donnelly?
What are pinball machines?
That's right.
Okay, and then it's partner.
Oops. In a Rolling Stones song, Siamese Cat of a Girl was under this. In the Who's song Pinball Wizard, the title gamer has such a supple this. Dan.
What is thumb?
No. Annette.
Wrist. What is wrist?
What is wrist is right.
All right, this is relatively new. This is the opening of the current show on Showtime, Masters of Sex. It's not for this crowd. I could have left it alone, but I chopped it up a little bit and took some images out, and so it's real quick. But it's, again, everybody, every time they watch the show, is seeing.
Get you, get you, get you all the way.
I did this just for Gary Stern, if I can find it, because he hates to see his not have it in this other. He hates to see himself in this, but it's.
Qualifies as pinball. Thank you.
Jones, Fox Network, did an interview at a live show at Sturman Park.
Do you remember playing pinball in the game's heyday? Chicago was home to dozens of factories making the machines, but now only one remains. And our own wizard, pinball wizard, Jeff Locke, is at Sturman Pinball to show us how they're staying in the business. I can't wait for this.
You know, David, we thought it would be an interesting day on this day when, you know, the latest video game is out, the Grand Theft Auto. We go back to a simpler time, but I'll tell you what, look at how these games are made. Does this look like a simpler time to you? I don't know. There is half a mile of wire in this pinball table, and we've been watching them, built and tested. Lots of things around here, maybe you see some of the guys doing the testing on these things. Fascinating to see the construction of these increasingly complex machines, but as you point out, what was the world pinball manufacturing capital? About 150 companies, we are told, it's very light. Back in the 1930s, now just one company left, and it is here, Sturman Pinball, in the town of Melrose Park, Illinois. And I'll tell you, they're making the latest Indiana Jones one. That's the big thing now, is to license movies and the rest. And John Borg is a fellow who designed the Indiana Jones game. Tell me about it. What makes this cool? And what, you know what? I got a bigger answer. I don't understand pinball. How does this work? What do these things do when you hit this and that? Explain the game.
Well, actually, the Ark of the Covenant is the main focal point of the game.
It's a movie.
And you shoot the ball in the middle, and the ball crosses the switch, and then the magnet, which is the little disc right in front of the Ark, pushes the ball away. And after you hit it a few times, the ball locks
and it's locked in. And what's going to happen here now?
The Ark lights up, and it's going to open up, and four balls are going to come out, and then you'll have this big ball in play. Three more will come from the bottom, so you'll have a total of eight ball multi ball play.
You are somebody who has not seen the movie. Whoa. I think we just did a tilt there. You haven't seen the movie, but you built there. You haven't seen the movie, but you did go out to Hollywood, saw the setup, multi ball play.
So, John, who's here at the show, you can ask him, told me that as the camera guy moved in, that game was on wheels, and he put his elbows, and he got really close on the machine, and it would have gone away if John didn't see. He put his foot under and caught the leg. Again, this was live TV, and it would have just rolled away. It would have been probably great. Camera guy would be on the floor, but that's what you see.
You are somebody who has not seen the movie. Whoa. I think we just did a tilt there. You haven't seen the movie, but you did go out to Hollywood, saw the synopsis so that you could design this. So you've been one of the people that knows what's going to happen in that.
It's a fantastic movie. It comes out May 22nd, and you have to see it. It's a must-see in the theater movie. Very cool.
John Borg, I appreciate it. You know, David, throughout this afternoon, we'll be combing the factory here a little bit. I'll tell you, I just got to be honest, it's a very cool place to be, whether you like pinball or not. I've been to a lot of factories as they go, watching these things put together, the complexity of these things. It's amazing to me. So anyway, we'll be back. Very fun time. Back to you.
I see multi-ball. I can't wait. You can't wait for
me. No, you're pinball.
We've got...
Okay, what do we got? We've got 13 minutes or something. Let's see. Want something like bold? We got Pinball Mickey. Anyone just shout out. We got, let's do Victoria's Secret. Yeah, that's Justin Bieber. No, we won't do it long.
Thank you.
the same lines, there was a Maybelline commercial that featured pinball, and I believe I have like a behind the scenes, but I can't find it. It's okay. This was the opening for Hell's Kitchen last season. So again, the whole year, people, you know, saw this.
Hundreds of thousands of chefs all across America dream of standing in front of these two doors.
Are you ready?
Yes, chef. Yes, chef.
Each season on Hell's Kitchen, one door is unlocked, and a dream comes.
Thank you. There was an experiment or a demonstration of a projection, something, projection, a method they projected onto buildings. And it's amazingly lifelike. And in this case, they use a lot of pinball references. And thank you guys, I appreciate it.